guys an album. How are you approached to do that?
It was kind of funny. We met randomly probably almost 2 years ago on tour. They were on Taste of Chaos and we were on a headliner, and it was like a blizzard in Rhode Island in the U.S. And we were both stranded at this one little hotel. And so we didn't really know who each other was, but we all like hung out. And so ever since then, we've been chatting and stuff. And then literally within 48 hours of the actual recording taking place, I was talking to their manager on like Facebook chat. And he's like, do you want to sing on the new Bring Me the Horizon record? And I'm like, yeah. And I happened to be in LA, and Ollie happened to be in LA, and they were just doing some extra vocals for the record, and it, like, the stars aligned for a second, and I was able to throw some vocals in. And it's just so cool. I'm a fan of them. They're great people. The melodies and the songs and the lyrics are really tight. Like, I'm excited for this record to come out.
Yeah, I'm really excited to hear it, actually. It's going to be good.
I hope you like it.
So do you have any advice for any girls trying to make it in the music industry?
I would say, I mean, the same advice I'd give for even guys. I mean, one of the biggest things that's important is you can't, I mean, some people make it as just a singer, but you've got to pour everything that you have into the music if that's what you love. Like, songwriting is one of the biggest things. If you don't have good songs, then it's just not going to go anywhere. Nothing's carrying your career. So I just spent so many years, this is based on experience, I spent so many years writing songs. I got signed as a songwriter long before I was ever really an artist. So focus on that and play your instrument like it's your last day playing it, and don't, just because you're a girl, don't think that you can try less hard or use that as a fallback. Like, play better than all the guys, and because you can.
So your acoustic EP was really, really successful.
Thank you.
Do you think on your new record you're going to go more of an acoustic sound or just go back to the more electro
things? I do love electro. I love synths, and it's definitely what I love making the most. The acoustic stuff is just meant to be sort of a stripped-down version of just to show the other face of the music, because that goes back to the songwriting. If you have a good song, you can strip everything away, or you can put all kinds of stuff on it. It's still a good song. It's not going to be changed. That being said, I think I'm going to use a few more organic elements on the new stuff. MIDI, which I use a lot on the listening, tends to, you lose a bit of life in it, so I want to bring some life back in, because the rawness is just so good.
Yeah. So you played Reading and Leeds and a few side shows. Do you have any more plans for a full UK tour soon?
I actually just finished a small headliner in June. I think we were here for it, June, May. So we probably won't be back for that until next year, as I'm doing a full headliner across North America this fall, so it's all kind of booked till December. But definitely coming back. It's not the last time, it's just the beginning.
Yeah. And last one, if you could hang out with anyone for a day, alive or dead, who would it be and why?
That's such a good question. I would really enjoy, that's because like the people I really want to meet, I don't want to meet because you don't want to know that they're real, like Bjork. I just wanted to meet Bjork. I would have to say Chris Farley.
Oh.
Wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah, it would actually.
Yeah. God
rest his soul. A good answer.
Yeah. I'd have a blast if I hung out with him for a day. Oh, Chris.
Awesome. Thank you.
Well, thank you.
It's been great to meet you.
It's a pleasure, my dear.
Brilliant set earlier.
Thank you very much, and enjoy the rest of the festival.
Thank you.